But again, if you don't want to serve Krishna, then you need to add that or get that propensity to some other person. So then you start, you open a hospital, so you go help people who are in need. And I think that's good. But the ultimate service, the only way you can ultimately serve anyone is by helping them getting back to their original dharma. Because that takes care of all the problems one go. Otherwise we can change. We can try to change the environment. So much pollution. How should we change it? Let's join Greenpeace and change the environment. But then you change, you get rid of the pollution in Argentina. But then what about the pollution in France? And you clean some part of an ocean, but what about all the rivers? And what about the cutting down the rainforest? What about the nuclear waste? So it's an impossible task. Actually, Bhagavad Gita says the only way to attain peace is by serving God. Bhuktanam yakyatavasam sarvalokamesvam suridat sarvabhuktanam gyatvam mam santim vrishtati. The only way to attain peace is by serving Krishna without any motives. So immediately we do that, we see a tremendous result. But that does not mean it is easy. There will always be, because that's the nature of it. If you want to change a habit, if you want to attain the highest goal, learn how to love again. Change that love that has been changed into lust, that is now this foreign environment, and has been changed into lust. If you want to change that back, it's very difficult. Actually, Krishna says it's impossible. It's not doable. You can't. But Krishna says in the same verse, but if you surrender unto me, meaning if you start serving me, I'll gradually take care of it. And as it's saying here, by I enter into their heart, bhavastha, riti bhavastha, I enter into the inner cause of their heart, and with the torchlight of knowledge, I destroy all the ends. So again, because we speak about dharma, we are not really speaking about changing. We are speaking about coming to our natural environment. Like when you're diseased, it's unnatural to be diseased. You have a flu. That's unnatural. But if you take the proper medicine and take rest and like that, after some time you'll get healthy. Because health is the natural condition. So in the same way, Krishna consciousness, to experience love all the time, is our natural environment. So the only thing we need to do is start living the way we are actually meant to live. And then that natural propensity will be reawoken in our heart by Krishna's mercy. And that's why it's so extremely powerful, but because it's not really what we do. It is how Krishna reciprocates with what we do. So Krishna, the supreme, unlimited person, he says, I will remove all the darkness in the heart and I lighten it from within. So the process works, but depending on how we put our heart into the process, Krishna says, I reciprocate accordingly. So it's, in one sense it's very simple, but in another sense it's not so easy. Because it's not, when you change a habit, it's not you change it for 10 minutes and then go and do your bad habits again. It actually takes you constant living like that. And that's what makes it very powerful. That you're constantly trying to dedicate whatever you're doing to Krishna. So it's not changing necessarily the activity, but it's changing the mentality by which you're doing the activity. So we all have different activities we like to do. Krishna says, fine, do them for me. Yat kadoshi yat asnasi, yat yuhusi bedasi yat. Whatever you do, you just do it for me. And immediately you change that mentality. Krishna says, then I'll take care of you. So again, that's what everyone can do. Everyone can change the mentality. You might not be able to change the activities you do, but you can change the mentality by which you're doing the activity. So it doesn't matter if we are living as a monk in a temple, or we are living as a person in the top of the Himalaya mountains, living in caves, meditating all day, or we are working a day job. Same. And Prabhupada says, if you're dedicating your mentality and your activities to Krishna by working, that is the highest platform of pure love, sannyas. That is the ultimate renunciation. So real renunciation means not giving up things or money or activities. Real renunciation means doing what we are doing with the right mentality. So who here cannot change the mentality? Who here cannot show gratitude every time they get some food? Every time they wake up in the morning? See, if we learn that art again of showing gratitude, then we actually start becoming normal. Because it's an unnormal, abnormal person who cannot show gratitude. If you go and give a person a very valuable gift and he just takes it and walks away, you see, that's a weird person. You give a friend a present, a new Mercedes, and he just takes the car and drives off. You think, that's strange. But that's what we're doing every day. Krishna is giving us all these gifts, now the sun is shining. We are allowed to open our eyes in the morning, and there's a whole new day waiting for us. We have our good health. We have money, we have facilities. Where is it all coming from? How often do we show gratitude? So unless we learn that art, we are not speaking about love. We are not even speaking about, excuse me, humanity. That's human. Human needs qualities. That's what differentiates us from the animals. The animals will just go and take. You see it anywhere, if you have cows going, you see it in Vrindavan or India, cows walking somewhere in the streets. And I'll just go to the grocery and eat some fruits and vegetables. He'll not go and ask, can I please have a, or pay him. He'll just go and take. No, human life means gratitude. Take something, you give something. So Krishna is giving us all these things constantly. But what are we giving? So that's love. Love means reciprocation. It's not only taking. That's lust. That's again the environment of material nature. That's lust. So the art of changing that lust back into love is Krishna consciousness. Our nature. I know you're already doing. But every day, if you do regular activities, spiritual activities regularly, they become very powerful. See, the nature of the mind is to constantly, it's flickering. It's constantly going there, and then it's accepted, and then it rejects it, and then accepted, and then it rejects. That's the nature of the mind. The mind is very unsteady. As I said, it's more difficult, Arjuna is saying, it's more difficult to control the mind than the wind. So the wind is very unsteady, constantly moving. So the mind is like that, very difficult to control. But if you make a regular make habits, so every day I will chant so and so long Hare Krishna, one round, two rounds, whatever I can fit into my daily routine. And I do it at this time every day. Just by doing that, that's a huge step. And then Prabhupada says there's two things we need to do, chanting Hare Krishna and study these books. Because if we only chant Hare Krishna, we will at one point forget why we are chanting Hare Krishna. And if we only study, we will become jnanis, and that's not the purpose. We will just become intellectual philosophers. So we need knowledge to destroy the ignorance, and that's what Krishna is saying here. He ultimately do. So, but he does it by giving us the facility. He gives us Bhagavad Gita. He's speaking. He's speaking to the whole world. So those who want to hear, they will change. And then by applying that knowledge, Krishna's removing all the ignorance. So these things, if you have a regular sadhana, have a daily regular routine, spiritual routine, that's extremely powerful. Because that conquers the mind. So when the mind even said, now I need to chant, I've made a promise to myself that I will chant 2 rounds a day. And now it's time to do that. So then the mind will just accept. Or at least it's easier to convince the mind. The mind will say, oh, let's go and eat. But then you say, okay, we'll go and eat. But first we'll chant. Because now it's 7 o'clock over there. Now it's 7 o'clock, 7 o'clock we chant. So 7:30, we eat. So thank you very much for your attention. Kandarat, Srimad, Bhagavad Gita ki, Jai, Prabhupada ki. Jai!